All right, today we're not talking about cameras or lenses or how to tell a story or lighting or anything like that. We're going to talk about the things that you need, that every person needs when they set foot on set. Whether you're a grip, gaffer, or PA, or camera op, or first AC, these are things you need. These are the 10 most important things. Let's get into it. The very first thing I'm going to suggest is something that I keep on me at all times, every single day. And that is a trusty pocket knife. I would consider a knife a very critical piece of gear. And it comes in handy a lot more times than you really would think. And more than just, you know, fidgeting and playing around and stuff like that. It's super helpful, whether you need to cut some gels, cut some tie lines, depending on the kind of knife as well. You could even use it to actually screw in a tripod head if you actually have a little bit of a raised part. Also, if you just need to cut some pieces of cardboard to make a makeshift cookie or something to break up some of your lighting to give yourself some texture on some backgrounds, go find a random cardboard box, cut some cool, you know, angles and holes into it. Now you have something that you can put in front of a light to add a little bit of character to your background light that you didn't have before. And also, some people may ask, smooth blade, serrated, combo. I've had both and I've had good experiences with both. I found serrated can be really helpful if you're cutting like rope or a tie line to whether you're rigging things or things like that. And smooth is really helpful for gels or foam core or things like that as well. So it's really dealer's choice on something like that. I would just recommend that it's a blade that you can afford, that you're gonna use. It's not gonna be too bulky to carry around. I've been really happy with my Spyderco Para 3 for a little while. My other knife that I carried was a SOG Trident. I had that for a long time. That was my first like everyday knife that I had with me whenever I was on production and on set. I will say though, make sure you keep it sharp, because you're gonna use this sucker a lot. Gels and foam core and any kind of like paper, like it's cardboard or foam core, it's going to dull your knife quickly the more that you use it, even if you have really good steel. So if you are cutting it a lot, if you're using it to break down boxes or even just everyday use, just make sure you keep that sucker sharp. So when you make those cuts, it'll be nice and smooth. The next thing I would recommend is something that some would say is probably the most versatile tool, because, well, that's exactly what it is. It is a multi-tool. So a multi-tool can serve a lot of functions, hence the name, but it's got everything. This really has everything that you need. It really does. And the plus side is that it's not too huge. You know, you can have it in a little pocket clip. You can keep it on your belt rig. There's just so many different things you can use it for. Not only that, there's a lot of different sizes, lots of different parts that can really either A, come in a pinch, or if you're in a little bit more of a remote scenario and you need a tool, chances are this sucker can do it for you. What I like about it is having the ability to have pliers. So a lot of lights are LEDs these days and just don't get that hot. So I find this becoming less and less of an issue. But if you are working with a light that is very hot and you need to either, you know, adjust the barn doors, or you need to take out a lens out of a light, sometimes those things get really freaking hot. Like if it's an old school, old face light, that is stuff that will singe and burn your hands, and you don't want that to happen. So what a multi-tool can do is you can actually use the pliers, grab it, pull it out, and carry it somewhere and set it down, and you don't have to burn your hands if you don't have gloves with you, or even if it's just too hot to touch with gloves. These can really, really help you. And also, if you have a pair that are like mine as well, you have some wire cutters, like let's say you have a cable that broke, or you just need to just, you know, break something real quick and just snap it. Wire cutters can come in handy. And there, you can always use it to crimp cables. Or if you have something that you really need to tighten down, like if you have a bolt that you need to tighten down on a rig, you know, you can use these to just bear down. Or if you have something that's kind of stuck as well, the inverse, you can use this to, you know, open that sucker back up. And then also, depending on the kind that you get, you can also get some that have knives on them as well. So if you either don't want to carry a blade, or if you just don't have one, this can be a backup. Or if you hand it to someone else on set, now they have the ability to have a knife as well. You can also get some that have flat heads or Phillips heads. So if you need to adjust or tighten down your tripod, do any like field gear surgery, chances are you've got everything you need right here in this bad boy. The next thing I'm gonna suggest that you have on set is a good pair of work gloves. Now, the reason you want work gloves is because one, your hands are gonna get sweaty when you're carrying gear around, whether you're carrying C-stands, cases, or just helping people move stuff. It's just good just to be able to have a good, reliable grip. Additionally, when you work with lights, kind of how we mentioned with the multi-tool, sometimes these lights get stupid hot, really, really hot. And having a good pair of gloves is gonna keep your hands from burning, but also your hands from slipping when you're adjusting and moving gear and helping other people out on set. When you're looking at gloves, get all leather palms. Don't get any that have nylon, because nylon melts under heat, which means that's gonna melt to your skin and burn the living shit out of your hand. Now mine, I've got nylon on the backside and some a little bit of cotton parts, because that way the back of my hand has room to breathe when it's hot, but the palms of my hand and my fingers are nice and protected on the inside with leather all the way. So you can get these at any store. You can get them at Home Depot, you can get them on Amazon. Just a good pair of leather gloves, super, super helpful. And a great way to protect your hands and make sure you don't burn the ever-living crap out of yourself. All right, the next thing I'm gonna suggest is a flashlight. So the best part about a flashlight is it helps you see in the dark. But for real, if you're working on most productions, whether you're on location or you're in a soundstage, chances are you're gonna find yourself in a situation where it is stupid dark and you just cannot see. A lot of times when you're in a stage setting, the only lights that are on are the lights for the set. So if you need to go back behind a set, if you need to go hunting for some gear or checking for power or something like that, being able to see is very helpful. And also if you're going up in a lighting grid, just being able just to see or help somebody else see that you're working with, very, very helpful. Or if you have a really early call time or a really late call time where you're on a shoot where it's the sun isn't even out or the sun is long gone, just being able just to look in your cases, find where your stuff is, it comes in handy, and it's a good thing to have with you. This next thing I'm gonna suggest really is more so helpful when you're shooting on location or just a place that you don't really know the state of the power situation that you're in. So when you're bringing in lights or you're starting early out in your career, you're usually gonna be assisting a department. And if you find yourself assisting the grip and electric department or working with the gaffer or anyone else that's rigging and lighting, one of the very first things that I did was I would scout for power. You're looking for places to plug in your lights, plug in your chargers, a place for Video Village, and you need to see what places have good power, power that's grounded and ready to rock. So I highly recommend picking up just a simple power tester so that you can see if it's good. Now, what is great about these is you have a couple different lights to find out the quality of the power that you're stabbing into. Whether it is grounded, if it's hot, if the wiring is correct, or if the wiring is wrong and it's considered dirty power, which means it could mess up your batteries, it could mess up other things that are plugged into. This is super handy. And it's also just a quick way to see if that outlet even works. And so when you go back to report back to your gaffer or anyone else that you're working with, you can be like, hey, power's good over there. That power sucks. That power is okay, but it's showing up dirty. So if we need it in a pinch, we can use it. But for now, let's use that one over there. So this is a great way to become your gaffer's best friend. The next thing I'm gonna recommend is a Sharpie. Now you can either do just a normal size, fine tip, either or. The best part about having a Sharpie is being able to mark or label things. I don't know, that sounds pretty simple, but you can use these to mark focus pull points on tape, or if you need to keep a note on something, labeling cards or media. And also, this is a bit of a hint, if you're working on a table that is black and it has a little bit of a scuff in it, you could take your Sharpie and just color in a little bit of that little scratch. And on camera, more often than not, it's gonna make it far less noticeable and it will instantly make your tabletop just look a little bit better if you're gonna be shooting something that's a little bit more closed up on a dark black surface. So a little bit of a tip for you. The next thing I'm gonna recommend is a place to put all your brand new crap. And that's gonna be a belt rig so that you can store all your wonderful production essentials. Now, You can get these in a lot of different places. You can get them at Home Depot or at Lowe's or Amazon, and they come in all different sizes. But the best thing I would recommend though is get one that has a loop so that you can use a belt. This one also has a little flap so you can actually tuck it in the back of a jean pocket if you wanted. That's up to you. I recommend the belt because that way it's secure and it's not gonna pull your pants down and you're not gonna be showing plumber butt to everybody. But this way though, everything is nice and secure and is with you and it's just at your hip. So you've got your Sharpies, your flashlight, tester, multi-tool, your gloves. And if you want to, if it's got key rings, you can keep some tape and things like that on there as well. But that way, all your needs are with you and anything that you could need is just, it's just right there, man. It doesn't get any simpler than that. All right, the next thing I'm gonna recommend is a trusty water bottle because shoot days can get long and it's good to make sure you hydrate so you know you don't pass out. More than likely, if it's gonna be a long shoot day, there's gonna be craft services, you'll have something to eat and to drink. But making sure that you have at least something for yourself to drink will make sure that one, you don't get dehydrated, and two, it's always good to make sure that you cover your needs first. Okay, this next one, it's similar to the water bottle thing to make sure you have your needs covered, and that's stuff to keep your energy levels up. That could be bringing granola bars, coffee beans, an energy supplement, or something like that, just to make sure that you're able to keep going. Sometimes shoots can indeed run long enough where you have to make up time, and that might mean your breaks are very small, which means your time to eat or get a meal may either be reduced or almost cut out. And so it's always good to make sure you have what you need to fill your stomach, to keep your energy levels up, and to stay focused and make it through the day. So I recommend having either some chocolate covered coffee beans or a granola bar, beef jerky, or even a jar of energy or focus. Full disclosure, I do have a partnership with ADVANCEDgg. It's a great product. There's a discount code down in the description, and this isn't a video sponsored by them or anything, but what I like about having something like this is that it's light. I can dump it into my water bottle or to another water bottle as well, shake it up. I've got a nice little boost that'll keep me sharp, it'll keep me focused and keep my energy up so that I can make it to the end of a long production day. Because when hour 10, 12, 14, 15 rolls around, and you got to load up the truck and break down the set, being able just to make it through and get done, it is a huge, huge boost to have that in your back pocket. All right, this is the most important thing. I know a lot of these things are great. These are good things to have, but above all else, this is the most important thing to have when you're on set. Whether it's your first time or you've done it a million times, it's to have a good attitude. I know that's like, can't buy that. Well, yeah, you can't buy that. You can't buy a good attitude. But the reason why a good attitude is important is because production and working in media and stuff like that, it is a team thing. You're working with a group of people to accomplish something bigger than yourself. Something that, yeah, you maybe could do it on your own, but you're able to do so much more with a group of people. And if you are fun and good to work with and people see you as a positive person, they're gonna want you to come back because they're gonna like working with you. So whether that could be a client that really likes you, a director, a DP, making those relationships by having a positive attitude throughout the day, whether production is on time, you guys are ahead of schedule, or you're behind and stuff's breaking and falling apart, be a good teammate and have a good attitude. It will serve you so well, more than you realize. I can't tell you the amount of productions that I've been invited back to, places I've had the opportunity to go to, and even a job or two that I've been able to get because I've had someone recommend me because they loved having me around and having me on set. They trusted me and they liked me. Having a good attitude will take you so far in this industry. Can't speak highly of it enough. Alrighty guys, those are the 10 things that I think you need when you're on set. If you feel like I'm missing something on this list, let me know in the comments down below. And if you have any questions about some of the stuff that we discussed, or if you have any other questions about the film industry or video or cameras or gear, you can find me streaming on Twitch. We do stream 3 nights a week. You can find links to that in the description down below as well. And until next time, I'll see you in the next video.